Now, last week, Arthur said our next celebrity was like a Tasmanian devil. Well, tonight, he's heading in a different direction, all the way to paradise. Dancing contemporary ballroom is David Whelan and Salome.
Oh, I'm excited now. I'm kind of nervous.
Coldplay. Yeah. Unbelievable. Paradise.
That was insane. I've never been that close to an orchestra in my life. I've been so lucky to play music for a long time, but I've never got to experience something like that. Like, they're amazing.
Forget the singing.
You can officially say I cymbaled with an orchestra. Was it good?
That was unbelievable. So this week we have contemporary ballroom. It's all about freedom, and also you will have lifts, high jumps, movements on the floor, which creates like absolutely fantastic atmosphere.
Unreal.
Bravo, much better.
Dancing contemporary ballroom is very emotional, and you have to really dig deep to kind of feel the movements. And this song is so powerful. It's so uplifting. Kind of is a match made in heaven.
Oh!
No, I didn't spoil. It will be like this.
Supposed to do that?
Music has always been my better art form, the one I connect with. And now dance has kind of taken its place over the last while. And I'm obsessed with dancing now. Live music is the most beautiful thing in the world. So I'm never going to forget this one. That's a fact.
Dancing contemporary ballroom. David Whelan and Salome Chachua.
Great job! Incredible!
Thank you.
Incredible! I just don't know. Like, when Salome is going through the lifts with you, is there a whiteboard? Is there diagrams? Because it looks so complex.
If I'm still here next week, I think I'm going to fly. But then.
You were flying tonight. You were hovering
kind of was,
off the ground.
Yeah.
How did that feel?
That was amazing. Big round of applause to these guys again.
Yeah.
I've never got to do that. Combine. Dance, which I've never done properly, and an orchestra together, and so.
But this one, incredible, Lorraine.
Well, definitely powerful and dynamic performance. I felt you literally, both of you, you threw yourself into it, quite literally, on the floor. The leaps, the jumps, the rolling off each other. But the highlight has to be, again, the counterbalancing plank. I mean, it just takes a lot of strength timing and trust. It was really, really powerful to see. And to add in the tango really fulfills the criteria for me, and to get the accents in there and the punctuation for everything that needs to be to see that tango clearly. I really think this was a great, great performance. Well done.
Great comments.
Arthur. David, what can I say? That was truly paradisiac. You literally ate that dance and left no crumpets on the dance floor. Seriously, you are majestic. You are incredibly talented. Those kicks, lifts, spins, and that plank lift, I mean, the power. This was the perfect contemporary ballroom for me. And honestly, at this point, you are leaving me really short of words. That was outstanding.
It was. Brian.
Can I just check, did you like that, Arthur? It
seemed like just a bit.
I think it was exquisitely expressive from start to finish. That's the first thing to say. When it came to the lifts, I also thought it was very, very clever. Maybe not wow, but clever. And I know you've got that massive shoulder injury, so, you know, some of those lifts where the girls are above your head, maybe not that possible for you. So to come up with these ideas, Salome, was very, very clever. Really well done in that regard.
She just needs this one.
You know, and in terms of the balance between the contemporary and the ballroom, You took liberties, but that's okay, because you didn't push it too far. You got just about enough of the ballroom stuff to keep me happy as well. So overall, what I would say, maybe it didn't quite get me off my seat, but it certainly kept me on the edge of it. Well done.
Oh, thank you. We loved it. David and Salome!
Arthur said you ate that dance and left no crumpets. I think he meant crumbs. Either way, are you delighted with how it went?
Yeah, it meant so much. Thank you. That went amazing. It went better than I thought it was going to be.
Good.
Yeah, earlier on it didn't go too well in my mind, and then I'm just so happy I did it.
The old mind can do that too.
Yeah, it can mess with you sometimes, but I think it was just the pressure with the orchestra and everything. It kind of gets into your head sometimes.
Yeah.
But I just only focused on Salome and them, and I had the time of my life.
Lorraine gave her the technical term, the counterbalancing plank. How many times did that go wrong before you got it right?
I don't know. I wasn't keeping count, actually, to be honest. There's a few wrongs.
A lot.
Too many times.
But practice makes perfect. It was absolutely amazing just now. Was it on your bucket list to dance with an orchestra?
It was on my bucket list to first sing with an orchestra in my life, but to dance with them, yeah, that was amazing. I don't know why you used that clip of me singing though. You could have chose a better one, but sure, look.
I thought it was great. But there is a one says blue.
Oh, that's Tree Tens talking, like, you know what I mean?
The shade is being thrown. Would you like to sing with an orchestra eventually?
Yeah, if they'd let me in, that'd be great.
Salome, do you feel that contemporary ballroom suited David?
Absolutely, yes. He did a fantastic job. Especially when he has this injury.
Yes.
Everything so top, and it was very hard lifts and overall complicated choreography. You're amazing.
Thank you.
Did you ever imagine a dance like this when you started out, David?
No, I didn't imagine getting here in the first place to week 8. I didn't imagine this. That was cool. That's a highlight, big time.
Salome, he seems constantly happy. Do you feel like he's just delighted
to be here?
You
should see me Monday to Friday.
Do you feel he's very happy to be in the competition?
He's very happy because he's very passionate in dancing.
How much would you love to dodge the dance-off, David?
I'd love to not do it again. I'm about to slice my toes open again for the second time today. So, yeah, but if I have to do it, I have to do it.
Yes.
To dance with them again, I suppose.
Well, we'd like to see it.
Yeah.
No, I'm not wishing it on you, but you know what I mean. The scores are in.
The judges have their scores. Brian Redmond.
For Brian, a 9.
Lorraine Barry.
9.
Arthur Gurren-Liang.
Oh, it's an astounding 10.
Woo! Nicely done. That is a total score of 28. Now, we'll be opening the voting lines in just a few moments. And then, if you want to help keep David and Salome away from the dance-off, you can text David W to 53125. Give it up for David and Salome! All right, all our celebrities have now had their time to shine in front of the orchestra, which means the voting lines are now open! Each text vote will cost 60 cents or 50 pence, plus your standard message rate. Call votes will cost more. Remember to ask permission from the bill payer before you vote. You'll find all